Very good. So we are like less people today.
Yeah.
And so that we can do a lot of exercises.
Yeah.
Okay. So the next time we talk less and we'll do more. Very nice experiencing, because it's always Tai Chi Qigong is always an experiencing exercise. It's an experiencing art. Where unless you do, you will not know. Okay? So today Tai Chi Qigong for shoulder and neck problems, or neck and shoulder problems. Now we all know sometime or the other, we all go through this phase of having some problem in the neck, some problem in the shoulders. Majorly sometimes the problem of the neck and shoulder is associated with your complete spine. Mostly everything. Sometimes if you are learning energy work, so you are always taught that any issue of the spine will affect your internal organs, any issue of the internal organs will affect your spine. Okay? So one reason for problems in the neck and the shoulder is your spine. Then there can be other reasons. It can only be your neck. Okay? If you maybe don't sleep properly, aligning your body on the bed, you can have neck problems. Okay? If again there is some issues with your leg or with your walking style or with your hip, even then you can have neck problems. If you are a person who is doing a lot of hand work and doing it with one hand, okay, and there is no balance of muscles on the other hand. Like if I were a person who is using my right hand, and if I have to do a lot of work in my right hand, I also should exercise my left hand. But if I don't do that, then the muscles of the right hand are built up. They build up to be so strong that at a certain point they become weak. But because no wear and tear on the left side muscles become very strong. Now when the muscles become strong, it also tugs and pulls on the bone structure and the nerve. Okay? So if this is becoming weak, this is still pulling a lot of blood, this is still pulling a lot of nerve power. Then this becomes more weak again, and there is no proper flow of blood going up to the extremities of your shoulder and your neck. Even then you can have problems. So very, to put it simply, this problem is also because of blood circulation. Okay? Then you can have neck and shoulder problems if you have lung problems. If you have breathing issues, respiratory issues, also your shoulder and your neck can be. If you have heart diseases, even then you can have shoulder pain and neck pain. Okay? So before you addressing or rather getting to know what you can do for your neck and your shoulder pain, the first thing you always go to a doctor and try to get your case diagnosed as what actually is giving you a neck and a shoulder pain. Okay? And after that, then the doctor tells you whatever you have, again there's no cause for being scared. You may have maybe respiratory problems, you may have lung problems, you may have your skeletal problem, maybe a cramp or maybe a space or a gap between the vertebrae. So you don't need to be scared, because there is always some kind of source which is there, which can treat you or bring relief. And the first thing is to get to know. Now these are all physical things. Okay? These are all very physical. Then we learn Tai Chi and Qigong. Then we go a little more deeper. So the first level that we go to is the emotional level. In Tai Chi and Qigong, we very firmly believe that your aches and pains, of course, comes because of physical issues, but it also comes in because of emotional issues. So what? What kind of emotion do you think can affect your neck? Anybody? No?
Breathing, cough or something?
No. Emotion, not physical. Cough is physical.
Stress is
a common word for everything.
But in exactly. Emotion, normally your mind and brain feels so heavy that it puts down into your spine and
yes,
all these
yes.
things.
But what one particular emotion? Okay. Like one emotion I can say is happiness. One emotion is sadness.
I think sadness.
So what can give you pain in your neck?
Sadness.
Happiness? Sadness?
Sadness.
You think sadness, okay? Grief. A lot of grief can give you neck pain. Okay? Then, attitude-wise emotion. If you have a certain kind of attitude also, you can get neck pain. Okay? So, what is the attitude? The attitude is not wanting to change. Okay? When you don't want to change, okay, and in the old days, I still remember my mom was half British, so she would always say, you know, you have a stiff neck when you don't agree with something else, when you don't agree with people, when you don't want to turn around and look back at your mistakes. She used to always use this proverb saying, you have a stiff neck. So when we don't want to look around and incorporate, when we don't want to look back at our mistakes, that means we have a very stiff neck. So though it is used in words portraying a physical kind of issue, but it is a emotion. So deep inside, when we feel, boss, I am great, I am a proud person, I will walk looking like that. I will not look here and there. If my enemy is coming from there, only look with the eyes, I won't turn my neck and look at it. Okay? Somebody has, you have said hello to somebody, that person didn't respond. The next time when that person is coming, you don't want to say hello, you won't even look at that person, you will walk straight. That also gives you a stiff neck. So these emotions also can give you neck issues, can give you pain in the neck. Okay? And not only from ordinary pain, it can give you severe pain like spondylosis and all those kinds of things. You have to be very same also with the shoulders. All shoulder pains also, though if we talk about it physically, maybe you are hurt on the shoulder, maybe you have a frozen shoulder, dislocation of the shoulder, you have so many things. But even then, there is another level, which is the emotional level. One emotional level of pain in the shoulders when you are carrying too much of burden. Okay? You're carrying too much of burden. Now, when you carry too much of burden of life, stressful burdens, there are two kinds of stressful burdens. One is useless burdens. Most of us carry useless burdens. Most of us. All that we are carrying up on our shoulders is useless. It's useless for us, it's useless even for the world, because it is not our burden. It is a burden created by energy, which you and I don't have control. Only we can change that kind of burden, then all humanity comes together. Okay? That is like war. Can a single person stop war? No. Riots. Can a single person stop riots? No. Floods. Can a single person stop floods?
Not sure.
Government. Can a single person topple the government? No. So those are useless burdens. You should not carry that burden, because alone you cannot do it. So that is left to energy. That is left to, maybe if you are a believer, believe it in God's hands. Or in karma's hands. Karma will take care of it. Then the next burden is your own burden. All the stress and strain of your own self, of people around you, those are the burdens that you will carry on your shoulders, which can again give you shoulder injuries and shoulder pain. That is one way of doing it. Okay. So one physical way we did, hurt, aches, pains, wrong posture, wrong sleeping, everything, injuries. Then attitude or emotions can give you pain. And then the last, the deepest meaning is extra energy in that area or less energy. The most simplest way to do healing, and the most simplest way and the easiest way, is to just forget all these physical things. Forget that physical side. My cushion was too thick, that's why I got neck pain. I slept on one side, that's why I got neck pain. Forget that. Forget you are a stiff neck person also. Okay? Same for the shoulder. Forget you are carrying the world's burden. Forget you are carrying your own burden, your family burden. You just look at that ache and pain as less energy or more energy. Okay? Now when we do that, when we do that kind of a thing, see, it becomes so easy. Isn't it? If you take it physically, the whole picture will widen up. Pain is there. What pain? Nerve pain, muscle pain, bone pain. Then you will go to the doctor. And you will have to go to so many doctors. As far as I know, for neck pain, when people come to me, number one, they have gone to a neurosurgeon. They have gone to an ophthalmologist for his eyes, because eyes also give you. Then you have also gone to a cardiologist. 3-4 specialists you have to go to. Okay? You see how the picture becomes wider? Then maybe you'll go out to a chiropractitioner. You may go to an orthopedic surgeon. You have to go through literally 4 or 5 doctors. I'm not saying don't go. I'm just showing you how something which is small can actually expand and become big. But here now when we are looking at the pain, we are looking at only 2 things. Less energy and more energy. If there is less energy, you bring in energy. If there is more energy, you remove energy. Now in Tai Chi and Qigong, this was taught to you who are in my class, most of you know. Okay? There are so many different ways. There is something called the soul finger, where you pull out energy and you throw it and you fill in pure energy. Okay? If you are not coming to class, then you should know that you are an energy being. We all are living on energy, all of us. However you want to believe, you don't believe. You don't need to believe that you are an energy being, but you are an energy being. There is some life force, there is some energy in your body, which is very difficult to the greatest scientist also to understand. Okay? Sometimes whenever I give this lecture, I am using this sentence today here, because whenever I give lectures, many a time I have seen people say, you know, scientists will find a way. Who are scientists? Scientists are people like you and me who are focusing and concentrating on one subject, and we become experts in the subject. You don't become master of the subject. Always remember that. We become an expert in the subject. We cannot master the subject. If we could master the subject, and now again, all doctors are very good friends of mine, including neurosurgeons and all the surgeons. If they could master a subject, you would not have to sign on the paper before going into an operation theater saying that the doctor is not responsible. Okay? That's what I mean being a master of the subject. If you are a master of the subject, you don't need that, because you know your work. You know how to heal the person. Maybe through surgery, through medicine or whatever. You will not ask for that. So yes, they are experts. Okay? You are pulling energy and putting energy. So we are all energy beings which we can use. It will be a matter of practice. If you are doing any other energy modality, whether you are doing Reiki, pranic healing, if you are doing meditation, if you are doing mantra japas, if you are a prayerful person, you go to a lot of church, temples, mosques, if you are doing Tai Chi, if you are doing Qigong, healing is faster because you know what is energy, how to collect energy, how to use it, when to use it, how much to use. That becomes so simple from a huge, wide, expansive, what you say, fear. It becomes so small to only putting energy and removing energy. And the moment you say it's only about putting energy and removing energy, don't you feel get a relief? Hari, this is so easy. Otherwise you're going from one doctor to the other doctor, from one medicine to the other medicine, from one place to the other place. You must have heard people going to cure cancer in America. Same medicine comes to India also. Okay? So that's why energy work. And that's why we always say, at least in my class, we always say, everything is energy and you keep it very simple. You don't need to make it wide. Remember one thing, the wider you make anything, anything in life, anything, not only energy, the more wider you will make anything, the more magnified you will make anything, the more deeper you will be in trouble.
Completely.
isn't it? A very simple example I'll give you. One of my friends had a very small house. It was a small room, kitchen on one side, one room, and a toilet and bathroom. And he was very happy. When he should go in his house, sometimes he wanted something, he would ask him, where is this thing kept? His wife knew at once. It is kept in this cupboard, in this drawer. True. Nikal diya. Then the progress came. Then they wanted a big house, one BHK. And we had one BHK when I went to the same friend's house. Then I gave him a paper, where do we keep it? Then he asked the wife will say, maybe in the bedroom or maybe in the hall cupboard. You see? What happened? You expanded the energy. Not necessary. So then they search in the hall, then they search in the bedroom. मालूम पड़ा तो किधर रखा है बच्चों का स्कूल के बैग के अंदर then you bring the paper out why because the small child also got a special place to keep his books now अभी बच्चा बड़ा हो रहा है one BHK will not do from one BHK to two BHK again the same paper where is the paper again in the hall in the kitchen in the child's bookshelf in one bedroom or in the other bedroom See, your path also to achieve something, how it is expanding. Something in that one room that he had, you could get it with the click of her finger. Now it is taking time. Same paper. It's taking time. So when you even look at aches and pains in your life, forget neck pain and shoulder pain, any ache and pain, any issue in your life, if you can compress it, it is easy to be distorted. But if you keep expanding it, then it becomes very difficult. That's why I always advise people that when you are not well and when you go to doctor also, keep going to one doctor. Let anybody tell you. I also had the same thing. I went to that doctor. I got okay in 2 days, 3 days. You are past 1 week or you are still suffering. No, don't do that. Keep going to the same doctor. It is very important. The doctor can give you a cure when he understands your problem completely. That is his method. That is his way of curing. That is his way of healing. So don't leave him in the middle. If you leave him, say you have gone to one doctor for 4 to 5 days and somebody tells you, "Arey, same, mereko bhi aisa hi tha, I went to that doctor and I got healed in 3 days. You stop him and you will go to him. Again, I bet you the doctor will not cure you in 1 day. Not cure you because he cannot. He has to study your case. So here you already wasted 4 days, again there 4 days. Again, you are widening the scope of healing where you could be healed at once. Again, you widened it. You are pushing the healing away. That's why here for us, it is energy and it is less energy or more energy. Okay? So coming back to, even if you don't practice Tai Chi and Qigong, you practice Reiki, you practice pranic healing, you do meditations, you do mantras, you do jap. You are a holy person, you are a God-fearing person, you love God. Okay, you are very close to God. Even then, just bringing in the thought process of the energy of that, what you believe in can bring you healing. Okay, like it is very simple. Okay, say there is some ache and pain in my body, and I think of a mantra. I think of the mantra, and if I repeat this mantra, it will bring in pure energy and push out all the toxin energy. And that can happen, even ordinary people. Again, why? Because I didn't expand the scope of healing. I kept it as it is. Now, why does this healing expand? Because we all know we have one physical body and we have one energy body. In the same way, the pain has an energy body. Okay, suppose if I have neck pain, this pain in the neck also has an energy. And the more I start worrying and the more I keep going to different doctors and all, the energy also expands. Now first the energy was so much, I could easily grab and throw it and maybe fill in more energy. Now as this energy expands, what happens? I have to pull out more. Okay? So that's why keeping it simple and having the concept of energy and having only simple concept in mind, less energy or more energy. So you can do with your hand, you can just place your hand. And as I said, no, you don't need to believe. You have neck pain, keep your hand, feel that your palm, there is energy flowing through your palm, it is taking out all the toxin energy. Then you just shake your energy hand a little while, then you keep your palm again and you feel you are filling in pure energy. You just need to do that with a lot of belief and commitment in yourself. Okay? Can we imagine the days there were no doctors? Man was still there. Man was still on earth when there were no doctors. What would happen in that time when the man would get fever? What would happen that time when the man's head is to pain? What would happen that time if the man fell down and hurt himself? Or what would happen if there is a wild animal who has bit or attacked that human being? When there were no doctors, where did he go? He had medicines of his own. Why? Because he never expanded aches, pains and sickness. Aches, pain and sickness for him were small things, which had sources of being cured and healed. So, it is like they say, isliye ek zamane mein they used to always say, even now some people tell you, of course, that is, things are changed, but even then, if you have BP, they would say, ye to paise wale ka bimari hai. If you have diabetes, they would say, hey, diabetes paise wale ka bimari, you got a lot of money, that's why you got diabetes. Then, when cancer came in, they would say, cancer ho gaya, ye to paise wale ka bimari hai. Okay? The thing is, as things expanded, everything expands with it. The more wider, bigger the aches, the pains, the sickness grows, the more wider, bigger the medicine grows. The more wider and bigger the medicine grows, the more wider and bigger our fear grows. The more wider our fear grows, the more closer death comes to us. Is it? So, regardless of the ache and the pain that you and I go through, our whole mind should be there. That it is less pain, less energy or more energy. Okay? Now in Tai Chi and Qigong, like I said, if you are a very good practitioner, a very good teacher, you can just lay the hand on somebody's neck, somebody's shoulder and you can take out the ache and pain. Okay? For yourself, you can surely do it. If you are not a practitioner, you can keep your own hand. One way of doing it is feeling energy is first just shaking a hand of stale energy. You just feel that you are shaking stale energy, then you rub your palm and you will find your palm becoming a little warm. The moment your palm is warm, you place it on that painful area. The first time when you place it on the painful area, feel it is taking on toxin energy. Now once you do that till your palms are warm, again shake it out, feel all the toxin energy is warm. Again place the palm on the same area and you visualize pure energy. It is so simple if you want to believe it. If you say, अरे ऐसा होता था तो इतना सब लोग डॉक्टर लोग बड़े बड़े थोड़ी होते थे, then तो बड़े डॉक्टर के पास ही जाओ. Okay? Right? So this is what you get. Then like I said, Tai Chi teachers can do distance healing. Okay? Or you can place your hand and heal. Or you can take out toxin energy and throw and fill in pure energy. One way is of doing it according to the meridian system. And we all know the meridian system are energy pathways in the body. Okay? So any problem or any blockages in the flow of energy in the meridian system will give you ache and pain. Okay? And like I always tell you that the energy system is like your nerve or like a pathway. Okay? If there is a block here, this area can give you ache and pain, this area also can give you ache and pain. So what you have to do is, here is what you have to see. So this is either more energy, okay, more or less energy. Okay, if it is more energy, you have to remove the energy out. If there is less energy, you put the energy. And the block is removed. If the block is removed, the flow of chi is again smooth. Okay, the chi passes through, the meridian remains healthy, the organ connected to the meridian also becomes, that is at sin. Okay. So now the meridians are inside the body. We can't see it unless you do some special photography to do it. Energy photography, aura photography only you can see it. Otherwise you can't see it. So what? Then there are exercises to unblock this. Now those are the exercises that we will do today. Okay? And you should remember that very important thing is whenever we are doing energy work exercises, we have to do it. And we have to do it very dedicatedly. Okay? Because they say that these energy pass these meridians are like rubber bands. When you start doing your exercise, they will stretch out. Okay. When you stop doing your exercise, it may twist back again and the block might come back again. Okay. So you have to keep doing it till this area is completely cleared of the blockages or till this area gets enough energy for it to remain strong and normal. Now this is for the energy. What else it does? It also, these exercises also works on your nervous systems. You know, sometimes when you go to the doctor will say it's a nerve pain, your nerve is twisted. So it also unclogs or rather reduces the stiffness of the nerves. Sometimes when you go to the doctor, he will say it's a muscle spasm because of the muscle on the neck. This muscle, this muscle, this muscle can give you shoulder pain. So it also stretches the muscles. Sometimes when you go to the doctor, he will say your bone, there is a gap or there is a crimp in the bone. The same exercises will also open the crimp or lessen the gap. So you are healing yourself on the nervous system level, on the muscular system and also on the skeletal system. What adds and speeds up your healing is the energy system. Because for us today, we are very firm believers in tablets and medicines. Of course, you should, in emergency, you should take a tablet. But we are more of that. Why should I put my hand up 10 times? I can take one tablet, the pain will go. Our idea of healing is that way. Okay? Our idea of healing is that way. If you take a tablet, what happens is basically your tablet acts like an anesthesia. Most tablets act like anesthesia. Most tablets, they numb that place. That's why you don't feel pain. Okay? And our body has an inbuilt ability to heal itself. So many a times we are taking tablets only to stop the pain and the body heals itself on its own. But when you are doing energy work and when you are doing this passive stretching of the nervous system, of the skeletal system and of the muscular system, you are actually healing yourself. You are actually changing what is happening there and also speeding up your body's ability to heal itself. So you will not only heal this pain, but you will build up endurance that that pain does not come back again. Or rather, you will not get any other kind of pain. That is how important Tai Chi and Qigong is. And that's why we promote it. So you can take a tablet, that pain will go, maybe next time another pain will start. But when we do Tai Chi and Qigong exercise, we are building up immunity. We are building up endurance that not only that pain gets cured, but we become so strong that other pains do not affect us. Okay? And it all depends upon us, all depends on us. Three levels of healing happen through Tai Chi and Qigong. One is very local or acute. You will be healed there and there, but there are other aches and pains which will come. Why that comes is because not enough practice. Okay? The other healing happens on the second level is that particular problem of yours will be solved, but another one problem will come. Why? Not because of Tai Chi and Qigong, but because you focused only on one thing. You left the other things out. Okay? The third level of healing is you become strong body, mind and soul because you are focusing on all the three harmonies that have to be in your body. Okay? So remember these three levels and how this helps you. Okay? So now we'll start with doing for the neck. Okay, you can sit and do, you can also stand and do. Some which you have to stand, we will stand. Some which you have to sit, we will sit. The first exercise is for the neck. Believe me, we have cured not only neck problem with this exercise, eye problems and also hearing problems. Okay, others sometimes to cure hearing problems, even in Tai Chi and Qigong, it is a little painful. Okay. So this is so simple, and again, to prove that it works, number one, you have to see my videos on YouTube where people give testimony, or you yourself have to do it. And you have to do it like I said, don't stop in between, because the energy paths are like rubber bands. You have to keep it stretched by doing it. After then it will remain normal. If you stop in between, it may twist again and create a block. Okay? Very simple, whenever you start any exercise, whether sitting or standing in Tai Chi and Qigong, you have to connect the central channel. The central energy channel running in the front of the body and running at the back. How do you do that? By keeping your tongue up. So you keep your tongue up and you slowly make like holes in your hand. Okay? Keep it down. Right? Now you slowly lift your hand up. Okay? And bring the elbow in line with the shoulder. Okay? Now this is here in the ears. Okay? Now slightly bring it forward, slowly. Okay? Not much, just a little. See, it is still in line with my head. Okay? Okay? Right? Now slowly again take it back. Now when you're taking it back, slowly bring this in line with your eyes. Take it back again, bring it down. Okay? Now first, you keep your eyes closed. You can watch me doing it first. Right? Now you turn to the left side and open your eyes for 1 second, seeing through this hole as far as you can. Okay? See for 1 second, close your eyes, and then you turn to the right side slowly. Open your eyes for 1 second, see through this hole as far as you can. Okay? Again you close your eyes. And again you come to the center, but remember you have to do it very slowly. You keep your tongue up. Now we will add the breathing. Okay, so first let's start this. We will do it for 9 counts, okay? Bring it in. Bring it in like this. Take it a little down. Keep your tongue up, close your eyes. Now inhaling, you will turn to the left. Open your eyes for 1 second, see through the hole as far as you can. Close your eyes, come back to the center, exhaling. Same way on the right side, slowly turn. Look through the right palm. Come back to the center. Left side. Open your eyes for 1 second, see through the head. Close your eyes, come back to the center. Right side. See, center. Left side. Center. Right side. See for 1 second. Close your eyes. Center. Left side. Center. Right side. Center. Left side. Center. Right side, center, left side, center, right side, center, last time, left side, center, right side, center. Now again, move your hand up, bring your hands together and bring it down from the front. Okay, so you remember, when you are taking it up, you make your hand like this. So you are seeing through this. Okay? Not like this. All the fingers, you make it round. And you have to see through this. If you see like this, okay, this hand has to be here. And you see, it's an angle, it's a sharp angle. Okay? It's a sharp angle. It is not like this. It is not like this. It is a sharp angle, just at the side of the eyes. When you turn, your eyes are closed. When you turn, just open, look through it for 1 second and close and come back. Open the eyes, look through and come back. And you should try to look through this like you're looking far away. Okay? Is that right? आप थोड़ा इस तरफ आओगे तो अच्छा होगा. वो दीवार बीच में आ रही है तो दर्द जाने के बजाय दर्द आ जाएगा आपको. लेट योर हैंड्स बी फ्री. ओके, दिस इज द इजीएस्ट एंड द बेस्ट फॉर योर नेक. एंड डू इट वेरी स्लोली. टेक योर टाइम. गो अप स्लोली. कम डाउन एंड क्लोज योर आई. एंड वेरी स्लोली यू टर्न. लुक थ्रू द पाम. वन सेकेंड क्लोज. कम बैक टू द राइट साइड. Open, once again, close. Okay? And when you finish, again take your hand up and you bring it down. This one exercise will do good for ear problems, neck problems and eye problems. Okay? You never know. Remember?
Nine counts.
Pardon?
Nine counts.
Now like this, nine counts you can do. One set, you can do two sets, you can do three sets. Don't do more than three. It also cures cervical spondylosis. Okay, it is also very good for cervical spondylosis also. Okay, now we will do an exercise which helps the neck and the shoulder also. Okay, for this you will have to stand up, but first you just see me doing it. So, first you take your left palm, place it on the right. Okay, and you flex the wrist. You move the wrist up. Okay. And look at the back of the palm. And you turn the hand. And as the palm is coming down, whichever side is paining more, you look that side. So if my left side is paining, I will look at the left hand. Now when it comes down, I will now place the right palm on the left palm. First I place left, now I will place right. Flex the wrist. I will go up. I will keep looking at the back of the palm. Now whichever side is paining of mine, I said my left side. So I will look at the left side hand as I am coming down. Now, which hand will come in front? Left hand. Okay? So whichever side pains more, you have to look on that side. If both the sides are paining, then one side left, one side right. One side left, one side right. Okay? Come, stand, we'll all do it together. So you get a feeling. Yes? Very good. Yes. Very nice. So, join the hand, left. Flex it. Now let the hand go up slowly. Don't worry, don't make your body tight. Loosen the body. Keep looking at the back of the palm. Now separate the hand and we'll all look at the left side, the left hand coming down. And look down, now the right hand comes on top. Flex, slowly move up. Keep looking at the hand, separate. Now we will look at the right hand. Right hand coming down. Cross it now, left hand on top, flex it, keep looking at the back of the hand, look at the left hand coming down, cross it, right hand on top, flex it, go up, keep watching the back of the palm, you look at the right side, hand coming down. Okay, continue once again, left side and right side, continue, the left hand up, go, very good, yes, flex it, keep watching the back of the palm, separate, look at the left hand coming down, again, palm over palm, right hand up, very good, flex it, go up, very good. Separate, look at the right hand, bring it down. Okay, set.
That means which hand goes on top, you have to look at that when bringing the hand.
No, not necessarily. If it's paining both sides, then once you look at the left hand, once at the right hand.
Okay.
Otherwise, you look only at that side which is painful.
Okay.
So if my right side is painful, whichever hand comes up, I will always look at the right side, because my right side is paining.
So whichever side, the energy flows.
Yes. Okay.
But my tongue.
Tongue should always be up. And you should flex it a little. Flexing. So flexing means keep it straight. Your hands are like this. This is like this. You have to flex it.
And tongue will be up.
Tongue will be up. Yeah. So I'll do it one more for you, once per time. Keep distance between your feet always, so that you don't fall. Some people, when they look up, they feel giddy. So that's why you should keep quite a good distance between the feet. Palm over palm, flex, and keep looking at the back of the palm. So up. Now I said my right is paining, so I will look at the right side slowly. And you see, I don't bend my elbow. I come from the shoulder joint. Out. Now keep watching. Now I will have my left up, flex, my right side is paining, so I will still look at the right side. Okay, so this also you can do on each side 9 counts. So you can do 9 counts of 1 set, 2 sets or 3 sets, but you need to be slow. And you need to breathe normal. So do not like this. Okay? Normal breathing. You have to relax.
But the knees, do we keep a little bent?
No need. You can keep the knees straight.
Normally in Tai Chi, you see the knees.
Okay. No, we can keep it straight. Right?
75% does exercise with knee down.
Yeah. Okay? So now, one we specifically did for neck. Now we specifically did for shoulder. Now we will go to the spine. Okay. Because loosening and manipulating the spine is very important for neck and shoulder problems. Either you can relieve the pain and the ache, but if the issue is lying with the spine, then it's going to be very difficult. Okay. So, for the spine, watch carefully first. I will do on both sides when I ask you, then you can stand and do. So, from here, again keep distance between your feet. Okay? You raise your left hand, let it go up, okay, and you can keep following the hand and flex. You look at the hand, at the same time, the hand which is down will make a fist, okay, the hand which is down will make a fist and come to the opposite side, okay. Now which side is up is your left hand. So you will slowly keep looking at the hand and push to the left side. You will hold it for 1 second and you will come to the center. Now, the up hand, the hand which is up, the left side will come down. At the same time, open the fist and this hand will start going up. Okay? Now when this hand starts to go up, it goes up from the front. You keep watching the back of the palm. And at the same time, this hand makes a fist and goes to the back. Now my right hand is up. I will twist to the right side. Again, I will bring it down. As this hand is coming down, I am raising the left hand. This will work on your whole spine. It will very slowly open the joints, very slowly close it. So it not only push in the horizontal plane, it will also push the vertical spring plane when you are doing this up. Okay? So it pulls. This will relieve most of the tension in the neck, most of the tension in the shoulder. Okay? Is that right? Now we'll stand and move. So you can follow me. Okay, I will face this side so you will know. Okay? Right? So let's start with the left hand going up, looking at the back of the palm. At the same time, the right hand comes at the back, makes a loose fist. Okay, look at the back of the palm, flex it, and twist slowly as much as you can. Come back to the center. Now, as the left hand comes down, you begin moving the right hand out and up. Now, as the right hand starts to go up, make a fist with the left hand. Flex and twist. And center. As the right comes down, move the left out. Keep watching the back of the palm. Twist. And back to the center. And exhale as the hand comes out. You can inhale as the hand goes up. Inhale till you twist. Exhale, coming to the front and bringing the hand down. Once again, we will do left. Inhale, sorry, from the front. And twist. Exhale to the front and down. The right side, last time, inhale. You can do it from the front, I don't have place. Twist. Whichever hand is up, you twist that side. Front. And exhale. Okay, relax.
Good. Okay. This will
cure many of your problem in the spine. Whether it's in the lumbar region, whether it is in the center, whether it is your tailbone. Okay? Be slow and be smooth. Fast exercise works for some people, doesn't work for other people. Whenever you do energy work, it will be a flow. It has to flow, okay, and it has to flow very smoothly, right? Again, so remember, again I will show you, when you are doing it, as this hand is going up, this hand goes to the opposite side. So if my left hand is going up, my right hand is going to the opposite side, and loose fist, not tight, loose, and keep it here in the corner, and you look up, and this hand is up left side, you twist to the left. Back to the center, then only you bring your hand up. Now, as the left hand is coming down, the right hand is going up. And twist. And down. Okay? These are the three exercises that you should do. Any degree of neck pain, shoulder pain, and spine problem, any degree, you can cure. 9 counts, 1 set. Okay, you can do it for 2 sets, 3 sets, depending upon your capability. Don't do 3 sets at once. If there is very severe pain, then you should do only 1 set for maybe 15 days and then add 1 more. If the pain is very light, then you can try to do 3 sets at one time. Maybe in that time only your pain will go. Okay? Because like I said, it's a healing exercise. Okay? Though it is strengthening you and all that, though it is raising your endurance, your immunity, but it's a healing exercise. What are healing exercises? Healing exercise, you should feel something there. That is called healing exercise. Okay? Healing exercise doesn't mean you come to me after 3 months, you will feel better. That is not healing. 3 months is ample of time for the body to heal itself. Remember this. I'm not against other healing modalities or people teaching healing. But you should remember, healing means you should feel relief at once. From 10% to 50%. Then, whatever you are doing becomes a therapy. Then it is called a healing exercise, otherwise no. If you come to me and I tell you, okay, come and do 3 months of Tai Chi Vimdi, then you will feel better. It's not a healing exercise. It's not a therapy. Therapy means you are going to help. It is going to help you, and it is going to help you drastically. You should feel the difference. That's why when people say medical Qigong, clinical Qigong, all Qigong heals, all Tai Chi heals. Today in the whole world people are doing Qigong and Tai Chi for healing, not for fighting. So there is no such thing. This is all a, what do you say, a brand. Medical Qigong, clinical Qigong, therapy Qigong. No. The person who is doing it can become a good therapist. Tai Chi and Qigong has already proved in the world that it works. But it is how I dispense it to you. Which exercise I show you for what issues and whether they are working or not. That is important. Okay? So don't fall for other traps. All Tai Chi heals, all Qigong heals, as long as you do it dedicatedly and the exercises are given to you right. Like I just showed you all for neck, I showed you all for shoulder, I showed you all for spine. Okay? If I showed you some exercise which was not pertaining to this, then it will not become medical Qigong. Then it will not become a therapy because it don't work. Now I know. I know how because I studied it. Okay? I had control groups to whom I gave this exercise and I seen the benefits. I seen the benefits from day one. From day one, we start writing the benefits down to from people. Okay, people with spondylosis, ordinary neck pain, nerve pain, bone pain, muscular pain. We write down, we make case histories. We make case histories and then we become therapists. Otherwise, I cannot call myself a therapist. And if you see my Facebook or not, you will see. It's always Tai Chi Qigong therapist. Okay, it takes a long time to become a therapist. It's not easy. Okay? So remember, all will heal. The healing exercises means you should get a little bit of relief. Okay? So these are the exercises which you should try to do. Try to do it every day. Again, I will repeat. So not only the healing side, it also raises your immunity and your endurance. It strengthens that area. And not only strengthens that specific area which you are focusing on, it strengthens your whole body. Is that right? We have any questions regarding this? No? Are you sure? No questions? Namaste. Namaste. Please pass it on. Namaste. Please pass it on. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.